So your first antenatal appointment is a very long appointment in comparison to the other appointments you're going to have. It's really important that you allow yourself a lot of time for this appointment. The midwife will meet you when you book into the hospital, and what will happen is you will be offered a scan, and this scan in early pregnancy will check the heartbeat, it will check the size of the baby and work out your due date. The midwife will also do your observations, where she'll check your height and weight and blood pressure, and then there's some tests that can be offered. So the tests included can be a urine test to check for any infection. We will offer blood tests, and the blood tests will be to check your blood group, see what blood type you are, check your iron levels, make sure you're not anemic. We'll check for contagious diseases, syphilis, hepatitis, HIV, and we'll also check that you're immune to chickenpox and German measles. The midwife will also do a booking history, and this history is lots and lots of very personal questions, including your previous pregnancy history, any medical issues you may have, any surgery that you've had in the past. With all this information, between yourself and the midwife, we will make a plan then for your next appointments and the route of care for your antenatal care. So the midwife or doctor can work out what your due date is using a method where we take the first day of your last period and add 40 weeks to this. So in theory, we work out that you're pregnant for 2 weeks before you actually conceive. This method is usually only very accurate if you have a 28-day cycle and you weren't on any contraception or anything before you became pregnant. So along with taking note of how long your cycle is and whether you're on any contraception or breastfeeding, and perhaps along with an early scan, usually these things can help us work out a due date. However, it's good to know that only 5% of women actually give birth on their due date. There is a couple of weeks before and after your due date as well. So ideally, to be as healthy as possible before you become pregnant. A lot of pregnancies in Ireland are unplanned. So from that point on, check in with your GP. Make sure to take your folic acid and vitamin D, which is really important in pregnancy to help your baby develop correctly, and also the vitamin D is recommended because we are lacking in sunshine here in Ireland. You would sign up for some antenatal classes to make sure that the information you get and you look for is good research-based information and not just a quick search on Google, which can lead to all kinds of weird and wonderful websites. The other thing that we recommend in pregnancy is to have your vaccinations, and the vaccinations are really important in pregnancy. We recommend the whooping cough vaccine from 16 weeks of pregnancy, and this vaccine, if given to the mother, actually helps protect the baby once he's born against whooping cough. The other vaccine which will be really important this year is our flu vaccine. And when you're pregnant, your immune system is slightly lower than a non-pregnant woman, which is absolutely fine. However, if you were to develop flu in pregnancy, if you hadn't got the vaccination, it's more likely to develop an pneumonia or something that will lead to more serious effects to yourself.